Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. How do planets form? It's a question that astronomers with ever-increasing frequency have acknowledged as unresolved. For countless decades, astronomers have subscribed to the nebular hypothesis of planetary formation, which proposes that planets form from a process of accretion in a cloud of gas and dust that has gravitationally collapsed. But with the discovery of thousands of seemingly baffling exoplanetary systems, some astronomers are now openly searching for a, quote, whole new theory. In our own solar system, recent science discovery has only deepened the mystery of planet formation. Consider the findings of NASA's Dawn mission at the dwarf planet Ceres, the first object ever discovered in the main asteroid belt. The mysteries include why the heavily cratered surface of Ceres features a surprising absence of large craters, why we have never found any meteorites from Ceres on Earth, and it's a puzzle where exactly Ceres might have formed, in part because it's vastly larger and rounder than its asteroidal neighbors. As members of the Electric Universe community are well aware, Ceres' massively cratered surface may provide clear evidence of the electrical events in which it formed. In this episode, Thunderbolt's colleague, experimentalist Jacob Gable, explores the formation and evolution of Ceres in the Electric Universe.
Ceres is said to be a young body because the surface lacks the number of craters to be presumed an old body. That would be using impact theory by counting the number of craters on a surface and assuming a certain number of objects will impact over a given period. I personally reject this hypothesis, that rocks and dust left over from stellar formations smash together in a destructive process to form planets. Also specifically looking at Ceres, its home is in the asteroid belt and is surrounded by possible impactors. I'm also well aware of another alternative theory, in which the surface of Ceres was electrically machined. This hypothesis is supported by what are peculiarities to impact theory, but are features readily produced during an electrical discharge. Craters that have craters perched preferentially on their rims, or craters that share rims, straight-edge craters that form polygonal shapes, and craters that have a sort of rippled ridge or distorted ring appearance. After observing electrical discharge experiments firsthand, I can say with confidence that most of the craters on Ceres are indeed formed electrically. Craters I've observed time and time again stand out like beacons on a cratered body such as Ceres. If this electrical hypothesis is true, what then was the source of such an electrical outburst capable of producing the features and bodies we observe? We find possible explanations to this question on previous space news. In a video done by Eugene Bagashoff titled Mars Mysteries Reopened, Eugene discusses the discovery of low-density material on Martian surfaces, asteroids, and comets, and these materials are suspected to be porous as a result of the low density. This finding gives rise to a hypothesis I will elaborate on after discussing another video done by Wall Thornhill titled The Saturn-Earth Connection and Our Place in the Universe. In the video, Wall discusses the discovery of the deuterium ratios of water found on Earth and water found in Saturn's rings and how it differs greatly from the nebular hypothesis predictions. Another point to make note of, the two ratios are remarkably similar. This would suggest that the Earth and Saturn were close by at one point, or even that we received water from Saturn, which is what Emanuel Velikovsky had suggested. Because there is a connection between water found on Earth and water found in Saturn, there is a conundrum that arises. That being, Mars, the asteroid belt, and Jupiter sit in between the Earth and Saturn. This is only unfortunate in a nebular hypothesis, but it is a possible clue to what might have happened in an electrical hypothesis where stars are formed along electrical currents and are subject to changes in those currents. Wall Thornhill also discussed a hypothesis he proposed, in which he suggests that the planet Saturn was once a dwarf star with a plasma glow that encircled planets in its vicinity. Saturn was then captured by the Sun, causing an electrical flare above Saturn and the resulting familiar solar system. I believe if this were to happen, the plasma or current from Saturn would have been removed and would have traveled. This could have caused enormous eruptions. In experiments with low-pressure discharges on silica, the electrical current can be shut off, causing material to be ejected from the surface. The eruptions can also be observed producing porosity throughout the silica, to make note of Eugene Bagashev's video. So it's quite plausible that Saturn could have played a more dominant role over the Earth, the Sun came into play, and stole Saturn's electrical current. When the plasma was removed, material would be ejected, forming porous materials such as asteroids, comets, planets, and even the asteroid belt. The ejected material would continue to move into the new plasma environment of the Sun, so it is likely that cometary phenomena was occurring on any bodies affected during such a migration. This could have also contributed to the porous materials. It's very evident that electrical phenomena are capable of explaining a wide range of formations. Formations of surfaces, entire bodies, and even formations of new stellar systems. Electric discharge should be considered among the possibilities for explanation.